In this question, we have given a matrix A and we have to find the value of determinant of adjoint of 2A. We can do this by finding, first of all, finding the adjoint of 2A and again finding its adjoint and taking its determinant. But it is too long process. So here we can use the properties of determinant to solve this. So we have to find the value of adjoint of 2A, 2A's determinant. So we know the property that determinant of adjoint A is equals to determinant of A raised to power n minus 1, where n is the order of matrix. You can also derive this relation by using the identity A into adjoint of A is equals to determinant of A into identity matrix. So here we use this identity and simplify it. So it will be, this is our matrix and this is its adjoint. So we can write it as adjoint of 2A, 2A's determinant raised to power n minus 1. And here the order of matrix is 3 cross 3. So the value of n is 3. So you can write it as n minus 1, that is 3 minus 1, which is equals to 2. Again, using this identity, we can further simplify it. So at determinant of adjoint of 2A will equals to determinant of 2A raised to power n minus 1, and n is 3, so n minus 1 will be 2, and whole raised to power this 2. So we get determinant of 2A raised to power 4. Now we can use the second identity, that determinant of any constant K multiplied by a matrix is equals to K raised to power n, that is order of matrix, times determinant of that matrix. So by using this, we can write it as our constant is 2, so it will be 2 raised to power the order of matrix, that is 3, times determinant of that matrix whole raised to power this 4. So here we get 2, 3 times 4, that is 12, 2 raised to 12 times determinant of A raised to power 4. So this expression is simplified into this expression. Now we can find the value of determinant of A and put in this. So let's find the value of determinant of A. So our matrix is 1, 2, 5, 2, 3, 6, 3, 4, 8. Now applying some elementary operations on this, we can use C2, changes to C2 minus C1, and C3 changes to C3 minus C1. So we get 1, 2, 5. Here we get 1, 1, 1. And here we get 2, 2, and 3. Now we can again use the elementary operation. C1 changes to C1 minus C2, and C3 changes to C1 minus C2. Then we will get determinant of 0, 1, 4, 1, 1, 1, and here we get C1 minus 2 times of C2. So here we again get 0. Minus 2 and minus 7. Now we can expand it along row 1. Now expanding it along row 1, we will get 1 and its sign will, we apply a negative sign, so it will be 1. Now expanding it, we will get minus 7 times minus 8. So it will become minus 1 times minus 7 plus 8. It is minus 1 times 1. And here we will get it equals to 1. So we get that the value of determinant of A is equals to 1. But we have to find the value of determinant of adjoint of 2A, that is equals to 2 raised to power 12 times determinant of A raised to power 4. So we can put this value in this expression and we will get it as 2 to power 12. The value of determinant of A is minus 1 raised to power 4, which will be equals to 2 to power 12. So the correct option is option B, that is 2 to power 12.